Hello everyone, welcome back to Natech Engineering. We are still on hydrostatic forces and today we want to look at what we call the general case of hydrostatic forces, which is where we are now having an object that is completely submerged on water at an angle. As you can see that this particular object is at an angle of theta. So how do we deal with an instance where we are having this type of a scenario? First of all, our hydrostatic force, it's not changing. We are still going to use the formula rho g a times y bar. The only things that are changing there is now our centroid, which is y bar, will no longer be from this portion, from this point to this point. We are no longer considering the length of the object that we are dealing with, but we are considering the distance from the point which will be the centroid to the surface of the water or the fluid that the water is submerged under. And the center of pressure, we know the center of pressure will be slightly below the centroid, but we are no longer considering the length of the object. Rather, we are considering the length, the distance from the point of pressure, the center of pressure, to the surface of the water that the object is submerged under. So now the value to calculate our h bar, which will be the distance from here to here from the center of pressure to the surface of the water, it's given by the moment of inertia sine theta divided by area times y bar all plus 2 y bar. And the moment of inertia is given by d bd cubed divided by 12. This is for a rectangle object or a square object, where this will be our b and this will be our d. And then we also have another instance where we are going to have, we have to calculate the moment of inertia for a circle. The formula that we are going to use there will be pi d raised to 4 divided by 64. This, the SI unit will be m raised to 4. Here, m raised to 4. So these are the things that we are changing or the new things that we are introducing, is that our wiper, it's no longer from here to here, from here to here, but it is from where the centroid is to the surface of the fluid. And our center of pressure is no longer calculated considering the length of the object that we are dealing with, but from the point where the center of pressure is to the surface of the fluid. So now, to see how do we go about answering questions on this particular scenario, we are going to do an exercise, which is an exercise that it's from my textbook. They say, determine the hydrostatic force and its point of application on the side of the plane in the fluid, given rho as being equals to 1000 kilogram per cubic meters. So this is the structure that they are giving to us. We have an angle of 60. We are given y bar is 100 millimeters. We are given the dimensions of the object that we are dealing with. Notice that here we are given, this is the side view of the object that we are dealing with. And this is the area that we want to work with. This is the front view of the object. We are working with the front view because we know that the force is not acting on this side, rather on this side, which will be somewhere here where the hydrostatic force is acting. So we know, they said we must calculate first for the hydrostatic force and its point of application. We said hydrostatic force, the formula is not changing. Hydrostatic force, it is still equals to rho g a times y bar, 1000 times 9.81 times the area will be this 0.1 times 0.075, and our y bar, it's given to us as 0.1, let me put it here, 0.1, which will give us 7.358 newtons. This is our hydrostatic force. Then they also said we must calculate for its position, which will be h bar. We know h bar, it's given by moment of inertia times sine squared theta divided by area times y bar plus y bar. Moment of inertia, we're dealing with a triangle, a right angle. It will be moment of inertia is given by this formula divided by 12, where our b will be 0.075 times 0.1 cubed divided by 12, which will give us 6.25 times 10 to the power negative 6. That is our SI unit. We come now to this formula to calculate our h bar. We put the values, this moment of inertia times 10 to the power negative 6 times sine squared, our angle is 60, divided by the area, which is 0.1 times 0.075. y bar we are given is 0.1 plus 0.1, and then it will be equals to 0.10625 meters, which can be written as 106.25 millimeters. It is from the surface, as we can see from the diagram, that h is the distance from the surface to the point of application of the hydrostatic force applied to the object by the water by which it is submerged under. So yeah, that's how we go about answering this type of equation. I will see you on the next lesson.